Want to make the start of your online webinar or presentation look more professional in just a few minutes? Well, by the end of this video, you'll know how to make a countdown timer in PowerPoint that you can use for your intro rather than the awkward wait for people that are late due to their back-to-back meetings. Also, watch until the end for a little tip on how to stop or help people having back-to-back meetings all day in the first place. Got new videos on Microsoft 365 and Microsoft Teams coming out every Tuesday, so make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified every time one of those comes out. I'm Gavin Jones, a former transformation manager for a Fortune 500 company. I now help organizations of any size with modern workplace transformations. If you'd like to find out more about working together, then stick around until the end. So we're going to have a look at how to create a countdown timer in PowerPoint to jazz up the intro to your online meetings, where you just wait for other people to join and you might want people to go on mute before you start doing presenting. So we're gonna create a countdown animation that helps people know that there is something happening. We'll show you how to move on to the next slide automatically after that countdown finishes. We'll have a look at adding some hold music because we're trying to make it so that people that are late to meetings all the time have a bit of buffer to join your meeting so that your meeting doesn't start late. Just like going to a dinner party and saying it's 7 for 7:30, you want people to be there so that you can start dead on time at 7:30. Same thing. So in the part two of this video, we'll have a look at how to try and help your colleagues out so they're not late for meetings all the time, especially your meetings are gonna start on time. We'll have a look at an Outlook setting that can help you do that more effectively and how to run your meetings like a formal dinner. So stick around until the end for those tips. So here's a sped up animation at the start of one of our webinars if you've ever joined one live. We now have got pre-recorded webinars which you can join a lot more frequently. So if you're interested in finding out more about making a modern workplace in your organization, then it's worth jumping on a webinar which doesn't have this intro because it's probably gonna be pre-recorded, although we still do some live webinars. But join at meetimeservices.com/webinar. There's a link in the description below if you're interested in finding out a bit more about that. But for right now, I've just shown you the sped up version of the intro because it is 3 minutes long. I'm gonna show you how to recreate that. We'll start with a new PowerPoint file and we just want whatever background. So the background that you use, I'm just gonna steal a template from this one, but I'll show you how to go and do it just so I don't have to start from scratch. Just so I've got the background and the logos and everything on. So we probably want to say something like, please join on mute, because we want everyone to go mute because we're about to present. And we want some sort of thing that's gonna count down. We've also then got some GIFs and things that are fun. So let me just get rid of all those for right now. So the first thing about doing your countdown timer is you want probably something circular. So luckily our logo is quite circular. Just go and paste your logo into PowerPoint, which is obviously what we've already done. It's just a circular picture. You can go and grab a circular picture off Google as long as you've got the rights of where you're going to show it. So all we want to do is click on the picture and we want the picture to be there and then slowly dissolve. So it's an exit animation we want, and it's the wheel if we want to animation that's going to come round. So we'll click on the wheel there. If I click on the animation pane, we can see we've already got one ready. And basically we just want to come into timing. Very similar on the PC app because I've used both, and we just want to set the duration to however long we want to do it. So I said 180 seconds, which was 3 minutes, which I thought was good. We're just going to do, obviously don't want it 5 seconds, but we're going to probably just do 30 seconds for the purposes of this video so you can see it in action. And even just that is going to be a nice little start to your webinar, but we can then jazz it up a bit. We want to make sure it goes on to the next slide automatically. So let's just go and copy in our header slide just so I don't have to recreate that from scratch. So in this, just to make it go onto the next slide after the animation is finished, if we come onto transitions, and we want to say on mouse click, so we can always jump ahead if we need to, but after 0.00. So that's the zeros there by default. It's usually like that by default. Which if we click on this slide, we can see there's no automatic next slide. But we want to move on to the next slide after 0 seconds. Well, that means it's going to go onto the slide 0 seconds after everything else on the slide has finished, like all the other animations, which is why we don't want another delay. We don't want to put that to 30 seconds because it'll be 30 seconds for the logo to disappear and then another 30 seconds of nothing before it went to the next slide, which is why it's zero. So even just that is going to revolve the slide around, and then finish. If we wanted to jazz it up with some GIFs, we could jump into Giphy, which is my GIF of choice, and say, I don't know, I've had some ones in about the timing, but say we just wanted this one, good morning, right click that and save image to download, which we do on the Mac, but it was going to be something very similar in the PC. And then PowerPoint can play GIFs back, so we're just going to drag that onto our slide. We'll make it so it doesn't cover up any of the text. And then all we want to do is, if we want to have that appear, say, halfway through the countdown timer, is then just mess about the in and out animations. So we will just have a nice fade in and fade out for this one, or maybe a peek in, say. Ooh, nice. And all we want to do is then just say, we want to delay that, say, by 15 seconds, so it comes in halfway through. And we want that to then exit, so maybe by, who knows, checkerboard, and have that at, say, 18 seconds. So it's going to play for 3 seconds and then before it disappears. Okay, so we just need to make sure the GIF is starting with previous, but then a delay of 15 seconds. Now I've reordered things. And then the end is with previous, a delay of 18 seconds. So the last thing we want to do to make it nice and professional is maybe add some hold music so people can listen to some music as they're waiting for that to disappear. Obviously we've only got 30 seconds, but you could have like 5 minutes, say, if you want to start the minute at 5 past and let all those people that are late have 5 minutes to join from the last meeting that's probably overrun. Let's face it, everyone hates back-to-back meetings. So if you wanted some music, I'm just going to go and get some free to use music off YouTube, which is in YouTube Creator Studio, which I've previously downloaded. You can get some free rights music just by Googling for it. And then to make it so it's the same length, we can use, so on a Mac you can use GarageBand, you can use iMovie for free. I use Final Cut Pro to do my YouTube videos, and we can just import some audio to that and trim it down to the right size. There's going to be something on Windows that you can do the same thing. If not automatically, then just get a free download to do it, because we don't want to do much work. So I'm just going to use iMovie on a Mac because it's free with a Mac. You could use this, do this on your phone, because you get iMovie for free on your phone as well. Just start a new movie. We're not going to have any movie in it. We're just going to use it to trim our audio down because it's quite easy and it's got the number of seconds and minutes in there, because that's what you use to edit video. So we're just going to open up a new project, drag our audio in there and trim it down to 30 seconds or whatever the length of your intro and countdown is going to be, and then we'll drag that into PowerPoint so that it plays automatically with our hold music. Cool, so we've got iMovie. I'm just going to drag and drop our audio file into the timeline, and all we're going to do is trim that down so it's 30 seconds long, so it matches exactly to the length of our countdown, and then we'll just do a nice little fade out as well, so it's say 5 seconds of fade out. Maybe with a bit of fade in as well. Then we're just going to export that audio only. We'll make it an MP3 and then we'll call that intro. We'll just save it into downloads. So that's done. We've now got cut down audio. If we then drag that in, we've then got our audio that's going to play. And then for audio player timings, well, one, we don't really want to see that. So what we're going to do is click on the audio format pane at the top, also on playback. We're gonna say play background, start automatically. We're doing a loop until stopped. Hide during show. Oh, and we'll start automatically. So we've put that up to the top and start with previous. So that's gonna be the first thing that starts is our music. So now we've got the countdown time that's going to go around, the GIF that's going to pop up halfway through, and that intro movie, and then it's going to go onto the first slide for us. So it's all automated. All we need to do is log into Teams, start up a presentation, and then click slideshow. So let's have a look what it looks like all together. So the countdown time starts going, the music fades in. Nice chilled start to a morning meeting. Before you even join the meeting, nice bit of calm, especially if you've got back-to-back meetings. The GIF pops up about halfway through, we set to 15 seconds, disappears after 3 seconds. Countdown timer carries on going round. The music's gonna start fading out, 5 seconds to go, and the slide will move on to to the start for us. All hunky-dory. What a great start to a meeting. So I'd love to know, comment below and let me know if you have that awkward silence when you were starting a video meeting in the past. And if this video has helped you out, if you're going to use the intro that we've just been through, then let me know as well. So if you or your colleagues are always strapped for time and have loads and loads of back-to-back meetings, research has shown that back-to-back meetings are terrible for productivity. You need to have some gaps in your schedule. And a nice way to do that is to stop Outlook setting the default time as an hour for a meeting. The only reason people have hour-long meetings is because that's the default. So let's just go and change the default and just strip us out of the status quo. So if we come into Outlook and then we go to File and Options and then to Calendar, what we want to do is shorten appointments and meetings. So first of all, the default duration for new appointments and meetings we can set to 30 minutes because we want to be having as shorter meetings as possible. If you're worried about team building, then just go to the pub after your meetings are finished, after you've saved all that time in doing what you need to do, and then just naff off and do some team building properly rather than spending loads of time chatting at the start of every meeting. Second thing you want to do is shorten appointments and meetings. So you want to end early or start late. I just like to end early and then just adjust the timings as we're going to go through anyway. So for meetings less than 1 hour, I would shorten it by the max of 10 minutes. And for meetings 1 hour or longer, I'd shorten it by 15 minutes. So I always say, if you, anything you can do in 30 minutes, you can do in 20. So once you set a default meeting of 30 minutes, it's actually going to be 20 minutes and finish 10 minutes early. Anything that you can do in an hour, you can do in 45 minutes, and that's going to shorten it for us. So then we'll click that and come into the calendar. If we want to start a new meeting today and we schedule the next hour, come in and do a new meeting request because we're going to send someone a Teams meeting. First thing it's done, look, 12 to 12:45. It stuck the Teams meeting in for us because we had that set as the default, which is a nice thing to do. But it's already reduced our hour down to 45 minutes. If we close that and we just clicked in and did new appointment for 30 minutes, it's just going to take 10 minutes off, so 12 to 12:20. Imagine that, all that time back. You can now fit three meetings in an hour rather than one. You've just been given the gift of time. So whenever we send it, it's going to shorten it down for us, which is great. So that tip should save yourself and your colleagues some time. If no one else in your organization does that though, they might still be having back-to-back meetings and still be late. So what I like to do is, assuming you have hour-long meetings, which as we know is now going to be 45 minutes, is give them 5 minutes to join. So we're going to set it from 12 to 12:05. And then that means we're going to finish at 10 to the hour. So we're giving them 5 minutes to get back-to-back to join your meeting, and then you could make a nice little intro slide that lasts 5 minutes before your meeting starts to give them a bit of time to chill out. And then you're going to finish the whole 10 minutes early and give them 10 minutes to get to their next meeting. Imagine that. Your meetings are going to start on time because everyone's going to be there, like a formal banquet saying, look, it's 12 for 12:05 and we're starting dead on 12:05. You've already got the agenda sorted, obviously, and know the purpose of why you are meeting and what actions or decisions need to be done or made during that meeting. Otherwise, surely you would have not scheduled the meeting in the first place, obviously. If you want some more help doing that, then let me know in the comments, or let's try and book a call for a free strategy call to see if it's worth working together to make your whole organization more productive. So we've just been through a bit of fun to make the start of your meeting a bit more engaging, and also some tips to help free up people's time from meetings at the end. If you're interested in changing the culture of your organization to make your employees' lives easier using technology you already pay for, then let's book time for a free strategy call with me. I'd love to have a chat and see if I can help you out. There's a link in the description below to book a suitable time. So check out these videos next. And if you like this video, remember to hit the like button, subscribe, and if you really liked it, consider supporting the channel by buying me a beer. It really does help keep free content coming out on YouTube. But thanks for watching so far. I'll see you in the next video.